back between the pipes of the Pens. First period, no score. Pascal Dupuis behind the net finds Jordan Staal in front. Stopped by Dan Ellis, who played a strong game for the Nashville Predators. Still scoreless. Moments later, Pens in a power play. Gonchar sets up Sid for the one-timer. His 42nd of the year, keeps adding to his own personal best, Jay. 1-0 Pens.
Yeah, just great puck movement. You watch. Crosby comes out, gives Malkin space, and then he just gets this one-timer, a perfect pass from Gonchar. It's a way to get it started.
Moments later, Tyler Kennedy finds Jay McKee sliding in behind the play, and he is robbed by Dan Ellis as he tries to go across, but Ellis is able to make the movement, still 1-0 Pens. Second period, Predators on an early power play to begin the period. Shea Weber will set up Martin Erat, who also played a good game. His wrister beating Fleury, his 19th of the season, ties the game at one. Moments later, delayed penalty, and Jay, the one you telestrated here, Jordan Staal turns the corner, drives to the net, gets it out in front. Matt Cook banging away at the loose puck, his 12th of the season, 2-1 Pens.
Yeah, that's just the power move that he has when he drives wide right there. Hard to stop that, and then just as a defenseman, you got to make a decision. Am I helping with the puck, or am I going to eliminate the player?
12 seconds later, the Predators answer. Jordan Tutu, who wears number 22, ties the game at 2-2 with his fifth of the year here. And, Jay, that's a big goal just 12 seconds after the Pens have taken the
lead. Right, as you talked about it, coming back, just a little miss. You know, they bump into each other right there, and then just a perfect shot off the post again. You know, kind of surprised everybody right there, but again, they battled back all day.
To the third, same score, and halfway through the second period, that's the one that we showed you is our right hand day play of the game as Fleury robs David Legwand. Game remains tied at two. On to the third now. We go in off the faceoff. And how about Brooks Orpik getting set up for the one-timer? His first goal in 112 games. Jay makes it 3-2 Pens.
Again, great for Brooks. Again, they shifted like that set play. Goes a little time. He rotates over. Look at the Nashville player is right there. Just a great shot by Brooks.
Later in the period, though, Marcel Gotch finds Shea Weber alone at the point. His snapper beats Fleury 11th of the season. And the slap shot there ties it at 3 at the end of regulation. No goals in the barrel.com overtime. We head to the shootout. Martin Erath scores the deciding shootout goal as the Predators shoot twice, score twice, win 4-3 in the barrel.com shootout. So the Pens losing back-to-back games in overtime and then in the shootout as they head into the Olympics.